What's good, crypto? I'm your host Marvin, here to bring in daily scoop on what's going on in crypto. After a crazy day yesterday with the news regarding Walmart and Litecoin, we saw a little bit more retracement yesterday with Bitcoin digging deeper into the 44,000. I think we're at the high 43,000, but I think we're gearing up for a major move and an exciting October nonetheless. We're going to talk about all the reasons why you should continue to hold, and the best is yet to come. We're going to talk about that and what I think, and I have a lot to back that up, and I want to show you guys a lot of different stuff. And then at the end, we're just going to wrap it up. It's going to be really, really cool. I think we have a lot of cool stuff to look forward to. And so far, some of the predictions from this one account has been spot on, and I want to share with you guys that exactly. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Media by Marvin. I'm a photographer. Feel free to shoot me a DM, message me. I'm active on Twitter and Instagram, so I'd love to connect with you guys. If you check into the channel, that'd be awesome. But let's talk about the market right now. We can see Bitcoin is beginning to get a little bit of a rally here, hovering at $46,450. If we take a look at what's been going on these last couple of days, we can see yesterday we wicked down to 43,300 after yesterday's insane news regarding Litecoin being the cryptocurrency of Walmart, which turned out to be very, very false. We can see there was a major run up with the excitement. We actually wicked up to nearly 47,000, and then we wicked down really, really low at 43,000. So all this hype building up above it, which kind of it excites me because it tells me, like, hey, wait till a day that we do have an official announcement of a major institution adopting cryptocurrency. Like, that was just like a quick taste of what it would have been like. But we can see after the major dip, we got to 43,300, and then we kind of started climbing back up, and we can see that this 43,000 area has been a major area of support. People have been buying it up. If we take a look, we can see we wicked down on the major crash down to the 42,800, and now we're developing another higher low at 43,500, and we're continuing to staircase up. And if you take a look at it on the daily, this kind of resembles what we experienced in the summer on the weekly. Take a look at the weekly. We got this major dip, then we get another, a little bit of a lower low, but we can see this kind of consolidation area over the last couple of weeks developing this low here in the months of June to, or May to July. And if we look at the daily here, it kind of looks eerily similar. And if it is similar, which a lot of people are saying that this is kind of what we saw in the summertime, is actually very similar, reminiscent to what we're experiencing now. And if we look and consider, you know, the months of, you know, from February to May, we see this kind of upwards movement, and kind of it starts to develop like this pattern where it gets around the top. We kind of see that going on here. But then we also get this major correction, and we're kind of going through a major correction, but we know at the end of a major correction, we start to climb back upwards. So it's very, very interesting. And if we take a look on the daily, right now we are forming a very bullish engulfing candle. If you don't know what an engulfing candle is, it basically, the candle that precedes the previous candle is larger and consumes the previous candle. So this green candle is consuming the redness of the previous candle, of yesterday's candle. So right now we are actually getting close to what we wicked up to yesterday. So this is a very bullish candle, and we are getting close. I think today or tomorrow we are getting the golden cross, which is incredibly, incredibly bullish. Typically when we see that is when we get a major move in price. We got a major golden cross before this run up from November to May, and we're about to get that again. So I think there's a lot of excitement, and I think we're gonna get a lot of really bullish movement for the market, which is awesome. But some things I wanna bring up to you guys, kind of the main topic of today's episode. Plan B, he is the creator of the stock to flow chart, that has been predicting how Bitcoin has been moving. This was a tweet on June 20th. My worst case scenario for, and this, he has a couple of stock to flow charts. One of them says, like, on the more bullish chart, that Bitcoin's going to go to about 280,000 coin by the end of this year, or by the end of this bull run, excuse me. He predicted that in June, August, the floor was going to be 47,000, or the lowest it was going to go. Which, if we take a look at the charts, looking back on the monthly, August, we closed right at about $47,000. Crazy. Now, if we take a look at his tweet again, the base for September is $43,000, which is spot on with what we just got this month at $43,000 as the base. So far he's been spot on. Last month we closed at exactly the number he mentioned, 47,000, and now we are staying and using the support, developing this new higher low at 43,000. His next prediction is October. The base is going to be $63,000. That is the base. That is worst case scenario for 2021. Worst case. Which, 63,000 doesn't sound too bad to me at all. That is $2,000 or $3,000 away from all-time highs. Then November, 98,000 worst case scenario. Worst case scenario. And December, 135K Bitcoin. That's worst case scenario. And then on his best case scenario, I believe it's like $270,000 or $280,000 of Bitcoin. If Bitcoin got to 135, worst case scenario, I would be very happy. I think everybody would be very happy. So this is what we have look forward to. And everybody says this, everyone that I follow that's been in crypto way longer than me. If you were to skip out of the 4-year cycle all 3 years and just made it to the last 3 months of the fourth year, which is this year, the last 3 months are October, November, December. These are the months you do not want to miss out on. So if you've been holding this entire summer, hold on tight. I know it's tough, especially in these last couple days have not been easy with the major crash, with everything going on. They're trying to shake you out of the market. I think we are gonna start to see the shift going back to bullish sentiment in the next week or so. We're already almost halfway through the month of September. Worst case scenario, greater than 43K of this month. We've already got that. We're holding that as support. And you can see on the price action, we are holding it and we are moving in the right direction. We are stair-stepping. We're taking our time. We're moving out from the second dip that we got back a couple of days ago, where we got down to 2,700 and we're climbing back up. And today is a good day. Today is a very, very good day. And the day is not even over. So really, really excited. I'm not going to make any predictions today. Today is the Apple event. I don't know if they're going to announce anything, but it would be crazy if we got huge news regarding Bitcoin and Apple. But I doubt it. But one can only hope. If they do, I'm going to look back at this video and say that I called it. But we'll see. But overall, I think we are in a very, very good position. So that's Plan B. If you don't follow Plan B, follow Plan B. Great information right there. But really interesting to see if we are able to get to 63K next month. We may. I have a feeling by the end of this month, we're going to be in the high 50,000s, if not 60,000s. If the base price for Bitcoin, according to Plan B, and if he's correct, if the base price is 63K in October, then yeah, we're gonna start seeing some volatility, some really good movement in the next 2 weeks. Next, over to Lark Davis. I want to share some stuff. Long-term holders are still buying Bitcoin here, and he provides a chart with the long-term holding that position change. And we can see over here in the far right in the green, this is accumulation. People buying. Whales are accumulating, buying, getting up as much Bitcoin as possible because this is an awesome opportunity to continue to buy before the second leg of this bull run. If we can take a look, Previously, from January to May, you can see a lot of red. That's a lot of distribution. That's a lot of people selling and taking profit during those months when Bitcoin was getting to 50, 60, so on and so forth. Again, people are taking profit, which makes sense. And now people are buying back in, buying more Bitcoin, because right now this is a beautiful time to be accumulating as much Bitcoin. And you can see this major spike when Bitcoin was down to 29,000, 30,000, but you can see still people are accumulating. And currently at 421,000 Bitcoin a month, people are scooping as much as possible. And it's all good that we can see that because of on-chain analytics. Also, another two other tweets I want to mention. We just hit an all-time low for young Bitcoin, Bitcoin that has been created or mined in the last 3 months, HODL wave. This often signals the end of a bearish period and is often time when big money accumulates. Retail hype money was buying Bitcoin in April, and now that is being sold to institutions. So people who bought at the top are selling to institutions for the low low. Bitcoin 100K end of year. And we can see here, towards the end, coins younger than 3 months, all-time low. So they're not being traded. They're being accumulated. They're being held onto. And new coins that were bought at the top of 2021, which I mentioned just right here, are being sold at a loss. And people are scooping up some cheap Bitcoin. Or not even a loss, but people are just selling it because they're freaking out. They have weak hands. And lastly, the Bitcoin Golden Cross will probably confirm tomorrow. This was tweeted 8 hours ago, so probably by the end of today, if not going into Wednesday. Here we can see that the Golden Cross, I believe this is one, the 50 EMA and the 200 EMA cross. Let me make sure. Or the 50 MA and the 200 MA cross. Which is really, really, really freaking bullish. And we saw this right before the major run in November. So I think we're going to see a lot of good movement going on here for Bitcoin. I think there's a lot of good things to look at Bitcoin. And then the last tweet I want to bring up, Rec Capital, amazing analyst. If you don't follow Rec Capital, please go follow Rec Capital. But he shared this. If Bitcoin breaks out of its current market structure, what do you think Ethereum will do? Of course, it's going to freaking rocket. We can see here, we have this this falling wedge that breaks bullish, especially when we're in a bullish run or a bull run. Typically, we break out bullish. We can see here we're breaking up, and then there's this other upper channel here, which is at about $46,200, which we are above. If we can close over that today, I think that's going to be amazing, and we're going to continue a very, very healthy and good recovery. I do think that this major sell-off that we had earlier regarding the cascading effect of liquidations of longs was just, you know, used to kind of shake as many people out of the market before we continue this run. And I think Bitcoin and Ethereum are continuing to do very, very well. I'm actually really happy for Ethereum. I think Ethereum is doing very, very well considering all market conditions, hanging out over $3,300. Ethereum has been doing very, very well. But overall, I think we are about to see something pretty exciting for crypto. I tweeted it out earlier today. If you go to my Twitter, I tweeted out, does anybody else have a sneaking suspicion that Bitcoin is about to make a major move? Pamp it up, please. But that's all I really have for you guys today. There's not a lot of crazy news, but overall, I think we are starting to see that the bullish movement in the right direction, a healthy bullish movement. And we can see after yesterday's craziness, pulling up the hourly chart, we are already above where we closed at the crazy hype story of yesterday. This is healthy. This is awesome to see the market. And we're starting to see some, this candle really getting excited. We're at $46,500. I have a really good feeling that we are about to move in a very, very good direction. We can see if we're able to get over this area of resistance of 46,900, if we're able to close over 47,000, I think a lot of people are going to start turning their heads, and I think it's going to confirm not only the breakout, even though I said where we are is a confirmed breakout, because wicks aren't that strong. We're breaking over this area of resistance on closed days on the daily, $46,400 about. So we're already over that. But if we can continue to move forward and start to approach the $47,000 region, I think we can say that we are going to start moving up in a very, very good direction. I think this was all just a scare tactic to scare people and sell out. People are uncomfortable in this area in the $42,000 to $45,000 region. I think we're gonna start moving in the right direction. I have a feeling by the end of this weekend we may be at $49,000, $50,000, but we will see. This is just a very good day. So let's keep it up, keep focused, stay strong, and I'll see you guys in tomorrow's episode. Have a good day, everyone. Peace.